What if we never went to the moon? When you look up at that big piece of cheese in the sky, it's difficult to imagine how life would be different if NASA astronauts didn't visit the moon in the 60s and 70s. Obviously, we know the moon affects the Earth and its inhabitants in profound ways, but would life be really all that different today if we never went to the moon? Welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. The space race began on August 2nd, 1955, when the Soviet Union announced it would be putting artificial satellites into space. The Soviet Union successfully put Sputnik 1 into space before the US, and also was the first to put a human into space, Yuri Gagarin. In 1961, John F. Kennedy challenged America to land a man on the moon and return him safely to Earth. The first man-made object to reach the moon was the Soviet Union's Luna 2 mission on September 13, 1959. Then, during the Apollo 11 mission, the United States successfully landed a manned aircraft on the moon on July 20, 1969. To this day, the United States is the only country to have done this, and the last time humans were on the moon was December of 1972. The Apollo missions changed the world forever. Progress in human spaceflight accelerated in the 1960s, and the number of physics PhDs at American universities almost tripled. So in short, the Apollo missions made America smarter. The engineering that was required to leave Earth and move to another celestial body led to the discoveries of civil, electrical, aeronautical, and engineering science. The race to land on the moon skyrocketed the pace of technology development. In order to control the Apollo spacecraft, MIT proposed a small, lightweight computer. When it came to the Apollo missions, they needed to cut down on weight and power consumption. It's around $10,000 a pound to get to lower Earth orbit. Hence, the Apollo mission required computers that were compact, powerful, but also didn't require a lot of power. Fairchild Semiconductor was experimenting with microelectric components, and NASA ordered 1 million of them. Two employees from Fairchild ended up founding the company Intel in 1969. The missions to the moon reinvented society as we know it today. They directly led to the development of the integrated circuit, or a microchip. Anything that requires microelectronic components became much more affordable after the Apollo missions. The moon landings led to the pocket calculators of the 70s, the home computers of the 80s, the World Wide Web of the 90s, and eventually, the techie-driven world as we know it today. Even the software in your credit card swipe devices wouldn't exist without the technology developed through the Apollo missions. There are many who believe the moon landing was a conspiracy, and that we never actually went there. In fact, around 5-10% of all Americans believe the landings were faked. So maybe we're already existing in a world where we never went to the moon. Just kidding. You wouldn't have your cell phone or computer to watch this on if we never went to the moon. But the moon landings did more for humans than just advance our technology and make us smarter. It made us realize that anything is possible if you put your mind to it. What was previously impossible became a reality. The moon landings made us realize what we are capable of. In the words of author and sociologist William Bainbridge, Apollo was a grand attempt to reach beyond the world of mundane life and transcend the ordinary limits of human existence through accomplishment of the miraculous. It's a story of engineers who tried to reach the heavens. I'm Charlotte Dobre for Life's Biggest Questions. Don't forget to like this video, share it with a friend, and subscribe for more answers.